Welcome back to this mini course on building vision applications with OpenVINO. In the previous video, we saw the instructions for adding emotion recognition to our face detection application. The final result should look like that, an application that can detect faces and can also recognize the emotions. Let me show you my solution. There are, of course, many ways to do it. You can track and run the solution step by step by running the Jupyter Notebook in an OpenVINO virtual environment. Check out video number 2 for all the instructions. Before we actually see the application running, let me show you some of the code. And again, this is only a recommendation. Here, for example, is a function that I called getModel. The function will get a model from the OpenModelZoo and will return an OpenVINO core object with the model compiled and ready to use. First step is to download the model. This is really just one line of code, OpenModelZoo downloader, the name of the model and that directory to place it, and the precision, which by default will choose to be FP16. Since we'll need to use it, this is a path to the model. And now, if needed, we'll convert it. This is again only one line of code, OpenModelZoo converter, with the name of the model and the directory. Now we declare an OpenVINO object, we read and compile the model, and that's all. The reason I've built this function is that for this application, we'll need multiple models, and we can use this function again and again for each one of them. For example, this is a face detection class, and when I use it, it uses the getModel function to download the model and compile it, as you saw before. Or use it to get an emotion detection model, like I'm doing here, or any other model I may need. Let's begin at the end. I'm reading a video file. You can, of course, bring your own file or use the webcam. And I'm running the main loop, and it's working. I believe it's nice and useful to understand the code, so let's take a minute to review it. This is the main loop. It may look like a lot of code, but all it does is to use OpenCV to play the video and get you a frame by frame for processing. A video is just a sequence of images, and this code basically gives you one image at a time, already with the right size to fit into the first neural network. And here is the inference. We're taking the input image and applying the face detection model on it. The result, as we explained in previous videos, are a vector of 7 entries per face, 200 of them. And now we take the results and extract the boxes. We take the boxes and using process faces function, we extract a frame, basically an output image to present, which will include the face and the emotion. First, we define the set of emotions, just as in the model description, and we prepare the input image for the emotion model. We are cropping the face bounding boxes out of the original image, so taking only the face out of the frame. Then we resize and arrange it to fit the emotion model input sizes. If you recall, the face should be 64 by 64. And inference, we are using the emotion recognition model on the emotion input, and we look for the highest value out of the emotion output using argmax. And all that is left is to add the text of the right emotion to the face at the right location. And that is all, running on a webcam or on a video. And here is the final challenge for this mini course. We have already seen how to detect faces and emotion. Now let's add the age and gender. Yes, I'm a male and I'm at my 40s. The model we'll be using can also be found on the OpenModelZoo. Go to Models, choose Intel, and here is the age and gender model. All the information you need about the model, specification, accuracy, and input and output. The input is a 62 by 62 RGB image, and there are two outputs. One is for the age, divided by 100, and the other holds the gender. If you look for the model, you'll see the input image and you can see the two outputs, one for the age and one for the gender. In the first example, we have resized and reformatted the input image to fit into the face detection model. And the output was boxes, rectangles around the faces. Then we resized each of these boxes to fit into the emotion recognition model. Now we'll need to take again the faces boxes and resize them to meet the age and gender model input sizes. This is the final exercise. Please try to play with it and I'll show you my solution in the next video. See you there.